All right, 5 minutes after 9 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in this Thursday morning. It is time for Veterans News. Hank Whittier is in the studio. Good morning, Hank.
Hey, it's a good morning.
How you
nice
doing?
And cool and a little cloudy. And,
very nice.
It's refreshing. It's kind of, it feels good out there this morning, guys. It's supposed to get down to about 49 tonight, I think. 49 tonight or Saturday. I forget which. But anyway, it's a nice change of pace. Get away from that heat. You got, I think you got Brian on the line this morning already and Terry after that, right?
Yes, sir. Brian, go ahead. Good morning.
Good morning. How's everybody?
Good.
Thank you.
Beautiful, beautiful morning. I do have 5 fatalities to report for today. The first is Richard Flosh, a fire captain, age 59, with 36 years of service, died on October 2nd. He was with the Milan Fire Department, located in Tennessee, and he died on duty of a heart attack. Our second loss is John Allison, a fire chief, age 51, with 20 years of service, died on October the 14th. He was with the Mason County Fire Department, located in Custer, Michigan, and he died of a medical condition, also while on duty. The third one is David Heath, a fire captain, age 48, with 10 years of service, died on October the 14th. With the New Hanover County Fire Rescue Department, located in Wilmington, North Carolina, also died of a heart attack. Jansen Frazier, a firefighter age 28, was a volunteer with the Odin Ridge Fire and Rescue Department, located in Eva, Alabama. He died on October the 17th, and he had just 3 months of service with the fire department. And he died as a result of a motor vehicle collision while responding to a fire call. The last one is Leroy Murphy. He was a firefighter, age 56, with 25 years of service as a volunteer, died on October the 20th, was with the Gettysburg Fire Department, located in Ohio. He died of a medical condition, and he became the 86th firefighter to die in the line of duty this year.
Yeah, too many, guy. Bad week.
Yep.
Hey, stress, Brian.
Stress from fires and law enforcement is like unreal.
Brian, be safe.
But thank you very much, and it's always nice chatting to you guys, and enjoy the rest of the day, okay?
Absolutely. Don't forget, you owe us a cup of coffee.
Absolutely.
All right, bud. Take care, man.
Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
And Terry's on the other line.
Hey, Terry. Good morning, buddy.
Hey, Hank, how are you?
I'm doing great. Hey, Terry, did anybody tell you about that breakfast we're doing on the 8th? Did Chris mention anything to you?
No, but I've been gone several days.
All right. Well, you know, we get together, you know, it's by invitation, but we get together and, you know, recognize some people in the community and been good to veterans over the last year. So, you know, I cut up a little bit and insult everybody in the room. And I think the sheriff's coming over and a few other folks. So, you know, if you got some time, come on over and have a little breakfast with us at the Elks.
I will.
At,
seven, on the 8th. I'm marking down.
Yeah, 7:30 in the morning. It's have your wife wake you up a little bit earlier that morning.
Yeah, I will.
Hank would not insult you, sir.
I'm looking forward to seeing you, Terry. Hey, listen, unfortunately, I know you got a casualty or two, right?
Yeah, we do. We got one. Unfortunately, we do. Not as bad as the fire guys got hit this week, but, you know, ours is police officer Patrick Hill, and Patrick was with the Detroit Police Department out of Michigan. His end of watch was October the 9th. Yeah, he was 13 years duty with the Detroit Police Department. Patrick was shot and killed while trying to arrest a murder suspect. Unfortunately, you know, this happened about 6 months ago, and he just passed on the 19th. He had served with the Detroit Police Department for 13 years, and just one of the unfortunate things of the business.
Yep. All right, listen, let's not add any names from Marion County, okay?
I'm here to tell you there, but we always try not to do that. That's our goal.
Yeah, listen, be safe. We'll talk to you later.
Thank you, sir.
Yep.
Bye-bye.
And, of course, we've got some military folks as well. So.
Yes, we do. DOD identifies Army casualty Sergeant Lyle T. Turnbull, 31, of Norfolk, Virginia, died October the 18th in Kuwait from a medical emergency. He was with the 62nd Expeditionary Signal Battalion 11th Signal Brigade, Fort Hood, Texas. And then we have a Marine Corps casualty, Lance Corporal Christopher O. Grant of Richmond, Louisiana, on October the 20th, while conducting combat operations in Afghanistan. He was assigned to the 1st Battalion, 9th Marine, 2nd Marine Division, 11th Marine Expeditionary Force out of Camp Lejeune, North Carolina. And that's all we have.
You got anybody here local you want to mention? Anybody passed on that we need to talk about? Mm-hmm. All right. Let's go ahead and do the Amazing Grace and taps, and we'll come back and talk a little bit about the fundraiser and activity.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fear.
Pointing your finger at me, Larry.
Of course he is.
It's your cue. It's your cue.
It's that to get my attention.
It's a cue, yes.
Yeah. You got my attention, Larry. Undivided. You didn't know. I didn't see you out there, right? At the fundraiser?
No.
I know you gave you money, but
right.
You didn't want to be seen with us or something? Or?
Well, my son was in a race that day, so I had to go. You know, I had the choice, either watch my son or make a fool out of myself. So I went to watch my son.
Hey, but don't feel bad.
You would have fit right in.
Don't feel bad because we know your heart was there. But see, on the roof over there, Hank's two friends showed up.
Yeah, kind of vultures, buzzards, a couple of buzzards over there.
Two buzzards.
Yeah, two buzzards, yeah.
They're still looking for
you. They're on the golf course. I explained, yeah, they were on the golf course with me the other day. That's how I was feeling out there anyway. Oh, man. You know, there were some good players out there. But, you know what it was? Everybody had a good time. You know, that's really... Don and I rode around, and everybody was really enjoying themselves. Maybe a few exceptions. Well, one exception. But other than that, that.
Yeah, that was Hank.
That was me. Yeah.
I wouldn't let him drive.
I was holding on for dear life in that golf cart, man. This guy drives. He's telling everybody else, be careful how you're doing on the golf course and how you cross and don't speed. And he's doing about 75 miles an hour in that little thing.
Well, I think the best part, Hank, is when we drove up to the Assistant Secretary of Defense and Major General Leacock's balls, and we ran over them.
Yeah, you did? Oh, that must have hurt.
Well, the good thing is
the golf balls.
You didn't give him the Purple Heart.
Yeah, listen, well, I needed a Purple Heart out there. You got, you want to talk about Cody's and some good food that they're doing? And
sure, I always love to talk about Cody's. They're a fantastic place to go eat, and they hand-cut steaks. There are several stores in the Florida area, but the two that we look at the most is here at Ocala at 2505 Southwest College Road. Their phone number is 237-8182. And then the Village, which we are very familiar with.
Yeah. Is
two numbers that I called here in Ocala is 237-8182. They'll be more than happy to give you a reservation.
More importantly, do they do catering?
Yes, they do.
They will bring it to your house.
They'll bring it to you wherever you need to be. Not a problem, sir.
Nice.
And you can order whatever you like, and you can eat a buffet also.
Great steaks. And, yeah. You know, salads, chickens, whatever you want. You know, as a matter of fact, he called me the other day, wanted to do something else, but we've been so jammed up with events that we really haven't had time to do another little get-together. But I want to do it, and I like working with Cody's. They're good people, and they do care about veterans out there, so... You know, go talk to them. They'd be glad to.
Maybe I can ask Larry and Robert if it's appropriate for, like, Hank when he came to my house and we had it catered to put stuff in your pocketbook and your bags and stuff and take
it
home.
You probably want the silverware back, too, don't you?
Sir.
You want the silverware back?
I do. My wife does.
I'll tell you where to get it. I think it's at Walt's Pond.
That's probably where it is. Walt's Pond is
Walt's and Jerry's. I kind of spread it around, you know, kind of with all the pawn shops in town.
Remember, Walt even...
I figure you stole it from some embassy anyway, so...
You got that one right. Was it the Afghan? Never mind.
All these embassies he used to stop in to sleep over, you know, he took a little sample with him. Anyway, get out to Cody's and, you know, buy a meal. And I think sometime in the next few weeks, a bunch of us are heading out there to do that.
Oh, well, they have some fantastic.
How you doing? We're just trashing you.
Look at this. Cody's walks in. Yeah. Hey, good to see you, sir.
We were saying, Everybody at Cody's except one is a good person. Scott, good to see you, bud.
I don't think you should talk about Dean when he's not here.
You got some specials coming up, too, don't you?
We do.
We were just talking about trying to get together with you. And you know what I'm going to be doing, and a lot of us are going to be doing Veterans Day. And I'll mention it because I was out there yesterday talking to them. A bunch of us are going out to Oak Ridge Dental.
We're giving the name out now.
Yeah, because they're going to go ahead and do it anyway.
Okay,
so,
fantastic.
And Oak Ridge Dental has volunteered their time and energy and expertise to take care of some veterans on Veterans Day. You have to be, either a homeless veteran or a poor veteran.
And you have to come through our office.
You have to come through the Vets Helping Vets program. I've got a couple of spots left, so if you need some dental care, they'll do some cleanings and a general exam and some extractions and some other things they can do quickly. But they, all those, I was out there yesterday. The dentist and all his staff have volunteered their time on Veterans Day, so that's what a lot of us are going to be doing that day. I won't be at the park or anything like that. We'll be out at Oak Ridge with those, you know, the poor veterans. And that's the hardest thing to get treatment for is dental care. Absolutely. If you're not 100% service-connected,
right,
or it's not affecting your health dramatically, you cannot get dental care through the VA. And a lot of vets are just don't have the money to do that. They're more concerned about putting food on their table. So those folks volunteered to do that. So we'll be out there from about 8 o'clock in the morning to whenever we're done. And if you're interested, if you really can't afford that dental care, you're a veteran. Not family's members are veteran, but you're a veteran. You need to call my office at 433-2320. I've only got a couple of spots left. So you can do that, and again,
now,
you
remember,
have to be, you know, again, it has to be a homeless veteran or a veteran who cannot, poor, you know, you're under the, you know, your income is very low.
What if your wife threatens to make you homeless?
The bad news is all of us in this room assume to be.
Probably so is Mount. Yeah,
Scott, too, probably.
I resume that
but, tomorrow. Well, you know, Scott said we could stay with him.
Oh, great. Thank you, Scott.
We'll probably extend that invitation to some of those homeless guys.
They could probably sew his jaw closed.
They tried that on me yesterday. It doesn't work. I broke the restraints.
Well, also remember, after they go to the dentist, they can swing by and stop at Cody's, and they'll give you a 10% if you're a veteran.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. That'll be a good day to do it. But anyway, that's what we'll be on. You guys know you called me about that, but we'll have a bunch of us going out there. We're going to transport some guys and be out there with them. But, you know, that's nice. Nice way to spend the holiday. And doing so, I can't say enough. I've been asking to get some free dental care for veterans for years, and these guys finally came through outstanding. So I can't say enough nice things about Oak Ridge.
That's great. That's
when you were out there talking to them, did I hear you scream from over there?
You know,
office?
I have to tell you the truth. I had a procedure done yesterday just because it's been a while since I've been, and they're outstanding. Real high-tech people. They've got a lot of real high-tech things going on, stuff I've never seen before, you know. They did the cancer screening and all that. They told me I was. They told me I had some, you know, intellectual issues.
Wow! I happened just to see the title on your records, and it said Abby Normal.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, yeah. Well, that just goes to show you know what you're talking about. There was no brain. Okay. Hey, Scott, what do you got coming up on Veterans Day?
Well, I wanted to come by and let you guys know on Veterans Day at all of our locations, we will be giving 25% off to all the veterans.
Not just 10, 25. So,
across the board on everything?
Across the board on all food.
Fantastic.
All food.
Very good. Outstanding.
Thank you.
So that's
Is that just
nice
the veteran or the family if he brings all his cousins and uncles?
That's for the veteran.
The whole
deal. See, but I'll tell you what, I'll give free peanuts to everybody else.
And they can throw the holes on
special,
the floor.
Special compensation for Don, though, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
But see, here's the problem for Don. None of his relatives want to be seen with him. So you don't have to worry about that. He comes in stag all the time.
That's all right.
And leaves with a lot of people. Oh, God.
Well, that's outstanding. So that's at all the locations?
Yeah. Okay. Villages, 20,
so
Ocala.
25% off your meal?
Yep.
Okay.
All day.
Okay, all
25%
day
25% off.
On Veterans Day itself.
Veterans Day, which is also a Kids Eat Free Day as well. So if you have any grandkids visiting or in the area, bring them in as well.
There you go. Yeah. You always have relatives at the house, don't you, Donnie?
It seems like it.
Very good. Okay. Anything else special coming up with you guys?
You don't want to reveal too much up front, you know. Yeah. But we will we'll be starting our big gift card promotion on November 1st for 2 months through New Year's. Mm-hmm. We'll be offering for every $100 gift card that you purchase, we'll give you a $20 certificate to use on top of it. That's good till the middle of February.
I'll wait to purchase those gift cards I was talking about. Thank you.
Hey,
I appreciate
it. No problem. But yeah, come on out. We hope to see everybody.
Outstanding. Very good. Well, again, you've been good to us. We appreciate it. I was telling them we were trying to do another event. It's just this time of year we get so jammed up with doing events and other things.
We'll do something shortly after Veterans
Day. Yeah, after Veterans Day, maybe we can do something and get some things going up here.
Yeah.
You know about our breakfast we keep on talking about. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you're coming over to that or not. But
well, that's a little early for me. I don't know. We'll see if I can make it.
Tell Donnie to... kick you that, kick you in the butt. That
but a free breakfast, I mean, you know,
free breakfast, yeah,
for the family.
Yeah, yeah. All my cousins are going to be in from Greece. There's about 100 of them. Really? I'll bring them with me.
Yeah, that's okay. And, just tell me how many are coming. We're good. Yeah, they don't mind being insulted, right?
No, they can't. They don't quite understand. Anyway.
I'm just smiling. They think I'm saying something nice about them, right?
Same thing they would do if you were there, right? You know?
Exactly. Yeah. 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 Someone told me that a long time ago. He says, Hank, all you got to do is learn how to smile. You can tell people anything, you know. Mr. Harrison.
Yes, sir.
Would you like to talk about Friday and Saturday and what we were all doing?
Oh, we had a wonderful time. It was for a worthy cause, and we did fantastic. I have to reach out and thank Chris Blair, Sheriff. What a terrific job his people did. And I can't say enough about his leadership and devotion to supporting us. It was excellent. They had static displays. They performed in the morning. They did great with the bagpipes and everything. I mean, fantastic. Friday was unique because we had the wheelchair tennis tournament, and they actually asked me to play. Yeah. And that was interesting because I didn't know you get penalties in tennis. But I got two penalties for over...
pulling someone's shorts down or something?
No, not quite that. But I was... what do they call it when you do something good and you jump out and celebrate and you get
excessive
celebration? I got a penalty. Yeah. I didn't know that.
And what did you do good, though? That's what I like.
Did a wheelie? Yeah.
I hit the ball over the net once. And these guys were fantastic. They were veterans, and they did a great job. We loved it, and the crowd loved it. Then after that, we had we went upstairs, and we had the silent auction. Couldn't have been nicer. It could have been better. It was just fantastic. We had great entertainment. These guys that entertained Forrest, it was just fantastic. We had the Ocala Orchestra perform and play the military songs. Then we had the Honor Guard come in and present the flag. And at the end of the evening, after Hank counted all the money, we had the taps. And the tapster was out on the grass with a spotlight on him. It was terrific, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was great. It was a great, you know, the perfect ending for a military theme night. And of course, Kathy Bryan sang the national anthem.
You know? She did a wonderful job.
Kathy's got a nice voice. She really does. Yeah, she gives up her career in politics. We'll sign her up in Nashville.
I thought she was going to wrestle you.
Kathy and I are supposed to do a 3-round exhibition boxing match.
I put my money on her.
I predict I'm going
to see that.
Knock her out. Knock her out.
You'd be better off hitting the lottery.
She will not. I told her, watch me in the clinches.
Yeah, that's right.
That I agree.
May not be able to break that one up. Then Saturday, we opened up this the ceremony with the bagpipes from the sheriff's department. They were fantastic. And we had about 127 golfers. If not more, we were just adding. Hank and I were going nuts because we're trying to put them all in carts. People were showing up that didn't even pay, wanted to play, and we had to do things. So we got them all out there. They were having a great time. They got all kinds of gifts, and we had all kinds of par three gifts. We had a Ford.
Yeah, you had the Ford. Yeah, yeah. You had a boat from Miller.
From Miller, we had a motorcycle
that was out there.
But they didn't bring the BMW, but they had the sign out there saying, if you got a hole-in-one, you get the BMW. Now, I thought it was like you own it. It was for 2-year lease.
You know why they didn't bring it out? And I saw some of the guys. I thought they thought the object of the whole hole was to hit the car.
Motorcycle. Oh, yeah, the veterans.
So they were aiming for the car.
You know,
Stevie Lawrence was actually aiming for the motorcycle.
You have to laugh because when we drove up to the hole where the motorcycle was, half the guys are leaning on it, sitting on it. I said, oh, my God. Derek Kelly's great.
He's a great supporter.
He's just laughing when he saw that.
A lot of good people out there, the Roberts family particularly, but just outstanding. It was, you know, it really was. It was. Well, I've been involved in a lot of, not just for the Vets Helping Vets, but with the Heart Association, other groups. It's the best fundraiser I've ever been involved in. It was outstanding.
Mr. Dunlap,
a lot of great people.
Thing.
What was it, about 250 there that night?
Oh,
300?
God. It had to be. We stopped.
We're close to max.
Yeah. We tried to give out dog tags to everybody that paid, but it seemed like everybody, they were just having a great time. Everybody got a dog tag saying, veterans helping veterans, American heroes shouldn't be homeless. And it was just a fantastic time. Yeah, everybody was enjoying themselves.
Presented the check to that young lady for help her fix her roof.
Oh, that's right, too. Yeah. That was a very touching.
Yeah.
Y'all really shook her up on that one.
Yeah, we kind of got her attention. You know, we got her into a home. This was a lady who was homeless a year ago, you know, living in a damn tent with some children, an Iraqi vet.
Yeah.
Who was hurt in Iraq to begin with and has a lot of health issues. Her children have a lot of health issues. We got her into a home. I guess it was about 7 or 8 months ago. But like all homes, they have problems, particularly when they're foreclosure. So she ended up with a leaky roof. And then one thing and another happened. We couldn't get her into a program we thought we were going to get her into to fix it. So she said, hey, I'll come up with some money. You think you could help us out a little bit? And because of that fundraiser, you know, we were able to do that.
Wow, that's fantastic. The Honorable John Grimes, the former Assistant Secretary of Defense, said, couldn't say enough about the benefit.
Yeah.
Could not say enough about veterans helping veterans, being a small organization that can handle the money directly with the veterans. He was talking about big time bureaucracy, which is killing everything. And he says, when you have something small like this, you can handle it and get directly. It's service faster, and it's more sensitive, and it's done with dignity. And he was really impressed with that. Not to mention that Major General Ed Leacock thought it was fantastic himself.
Yeah, got a lot of real positive feedback. But, you know, I think a lot of us have, that's our sort of our political philosophy anyway. The closer you do it to home, the better off you are. You don't need a big bureaucracy doing this stuff.
No.
And the money stays right here in the county.
Well, it stays here. That's right. And you know what? You get to know the people who are getting the help. And that's why we had some fun. And Brian came. And Brian, I thought Brian was very articulate. Talking about the help you got, we kept, you know, got an apartment for him and all that stuff. So, you know, that the nice thing is here you can actually meet the folks that you're helping out, and you know the money's not going into Don's pocket.
Yet.
Well,
all of it. Although the politicians were there. Yeah. You know how cold it gets in Minnesota?
Yeah, I understand.
The politicians walk around with their hands in their own pockets.
Yeah.
But I have to mention this because of the veterans and the active military and the reserves and the guards. They took it on their own to come, even though the government shut down.
Yeah, I agree.
And they did a lot of good work, and they were visible, and they tried to help and support the whole event. And you know, next year it's going to be bigger, better, and fantastic. And Hank, you can go ahead and talk about how well we did.
We're still counting because we did a silent auction that night, and we had some people in there who we partnership with because. But anyway, we don't have a final count. But as of Friday night, we had $100,000.
Okay. Oh yeah.
It was always nice
chunk of change.
Nice chunk of change. That helps. Yeah. Believe me, that helps a lot of poor veterans. Doesn't help the administrator. It doesn't help anything else. It helps the veterans who need it. So.
And that's what you have going for you.
Yeah, I think so. So anyway, again, there's probably someone I forgot to say thank you to, and that's your fear that there's somebody out there that you didn't get a chance to grab a hold of and tell officially thank you. But if I didn't, it was an oversight. You know, call me and I'll apologize to you and I'll say thank you again. But there were so many people that just outstanding. And not just the folks who put it all together and that worked so hard to do it, but those folks who wrote those checks and played golf or played tennis, or just some of them didn't do anything but write a check and say, hey, I'm not interested in coming. I just want to help you guys out. So really appreciate it. So we're at $100,000. We'll probably get up to a little bit more than that, but by the time we count all the silent auction stuff and see what we did, outstanding night.
It's interesting. I'd just like to add one more thing. It's the stuff that you thought would never go.
Yeah.
You know, we had a flag from the USS Constitution.
Yeah, that went big bucks, yeah.
That was 3,000.
Yeah, you did so well, Don. I got you a pistol. I'm actually going to get you ammunition for it now.
But the
no ammo.
The pistol's on recall.
Yeah. Now that's not by accident. That wasn't because of the pistol. It's because
no
of you.
Ammo.
Yeah, they were trying to slow the process down a little bit. Larry, I know you got to take a break because you got to sell something or other out there. Or...
He's got to get paid.
Well, listen, he does it. He does it because he has so many good things he wants to talk about. Huh?
Might be a Cody's ad.
It probably is. Yeah,
I'm sure it's
not you talking.
No way around it. We got Cody.
All right, we'll be right back.
Looking for hand-cut steaks or just plain good food made from scratch daily? Then head over to Cody's Original Roadhouse for a fun, casual family.
21 minutes before 10 o'clock. Let's rejoin Veterans News and Hank Whittier. Hank?
I'm back. Yeah, listen, I wish you folks could see what's up. You know, I've been saying this for years. If they could see and hear some of the things that go on when we're off the air. You got a big window here. I'm surprised you allow that sort of stuff to go on. And we're cutting up as usual back again. All right, let's talk about Cody's a little bit more, because they really have been a good partnership for us, and been generous to us. And but better than that, they've got good food and good people over there at all their locations. So
super nice.
Go out there and have lunch, dinner, have a couple of drinks if that's your inclination, and a bunch of us are coming.
Anyway, talking about Cody's restaurant, that's original Roadhouse, and they do hand-cut steaks, and they're just plain good eating foods that they have. They're located here in Ocala, and in the Villages, they have the two here. The Ocala one is 2505 Southwest College Road, and the Villages in Sumter Landing, and it's 1041 Lakeshore Drive. Now, they have two other stores also in the state of Florida. One is in Gainesville on Archer Road, mm-hmm. and the other is in Tallahassee. So you can go to any of them. They have happy hour from 11 to 7 every day, and they open at 11 a.m. and close when they get complete.
Yeah, food is good. People are nice. They'll treat you well. Yeah. And on Veterans Day, they're going to give you 25% off your meal.
25%, not 10. And every day, they will give you 10%, but on special for Veterans Day.
Yeah, you got to be a veteran. You can't tell them, I used to date a veteran.
No, nope, doesn't work.
I had an accident.
The truth finally comes out.
Phone call? Yeah. Yes, sir, you have a phone call.
It's probably somebody Donnie promised
the
something.
The truth came out.
You know, they're actually glad to have you back here, Hank, instead of me.
I haven't here very much. I know that.
Yeah. But,
you're back now. Praise him.
Go ahead.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry.
Good morning. You're on the air.
Whoever it is.
Good morning, veterans, and especially
hey, Mark,
Marines.
How you doing?
Great, guys. Semper Fidelis. I noticed you had your event while I was gone, and you're very humble men. All of you are very humble, and no one's given you guys thanks. So, as a veteran, speaking for myself and the Ocala community, you guys deserve a lot of thanks. It shows that you do truly care about veterans. I wanted to just make an observation about an interview which was given on Sunday on 60 Minutes with the former Vice President Dick Cheney, not a veteran,
and asked
about the cause of the war with Iraq, and his answer was, we were after 9/11, and understandably, you know, you can get all excited if you don't have self-discipline, but that they were just looking for somebody's tail to kick, was the word he used, but... The result of that, for the people that have that political inclination, if, as a veteran, if you want to see the results of the cowboy cavalier mentality, there's a website that actually the Department of Defense resorts to using itself now. It's called iCasualties, the letter I, with no space, iCasualties.org. And you can see where every soldier and nature of injury and extent of injury, actually, where they're from, what state they're from, what branch of the service, and also what military unit, date. And it's a very a sobering website, but it's called iCasualties.org. And also another website is VoteVets.org. It's a very pro-veterans website driven by a former Army infantry captain. And that's all I got. But I would thank you again for putting on such a good event.
Hey, Mark. And thank you for that. And again, it's not us. It's it's all the other folks that were. I mean, I have to tell you, there were hundreds of volunteers that did hundreds of things. And it's humbling work. And, you know, they did it because they wanted to help some veterans out. And that's really why they did it. And sometimes you and I disagree politically. But, you know, I agree with you. You know, we'll mention something. I was watching the other day. I happened to see a tape of a doctor here in town that served with the 3rd Marines in Vietnam that he made to show.
and Don had it and gave it to me. And if you really want to see what war is about, you know, it's not clean and neat and waving the flag. It's about some pretty gory stuff, you know. And that's really, so before we send people into harm's way, and sometimes you have to, we really need to think it through. It shouldn't be about, you know, the Wild West and cowboy mentality. So anyway, Mark, I appreciate it. You be safe out there, buddy.
All right, Semper Fi, and Semper Fi. Thanks for all the work that all of you guys do.
Thanks, Mark. Semper Fi.
You're welcome, Don.
Semper Fi.
Semper Fi.
I told you, Vivian. I showed that thing to Vivian, you know, that tape. I mean,
She didn't get it, did she?
Yeah, you know,
she got it.
She got it. You can't watch this thing without getting it. He actually took photos while he was in the operating room, operating on with the 3rd Marines up in the northern part of Vietnam. You know, they were about 12 miles from the DMZ and operating on Marines and civilians. You know, I guess sometimes we forget that what we did in Vietnam. It wasn't all fighting. It was, you know, a lot of humanitarian things going on, and he was helping the local community. Right. But as he's operating, he's talking about the, you know, the dust coming in from their underground hospital, from the shells coming in and, you know, bursting around them. And, you know, you learn to appreciate what people do, but particularly people who are in the medical field, because they're trying, under the worst of circumstances, they're trying their best to save lives. Right?
Oh, absolutely.
And the good news is he didn't save yours. I would have really been angry with him.
You know, actually, he thought he did. He said, no. It would have been sloppier. No,
I would have given him a second chance if I had. Put you back on the table.
You know, actually, we're in the same area, him and I. And but the only,
what do you mean,
difference,
the same area?
Up in northern Vietnam.
Oh, were you up there too?
Yeah. Oh yeah, Quang Tri Province.
You know, there's two or three guys, and we're gonna take a phone call. There's two or three guys that I know that were there at the same time he was there. They must have crossed paths. Don Williams is one. Don, I think, probably built that underground hospital because he was combat engineer.
Yeah, but they don't get to meet the doctors. They don't work with them.
Yeah, they just build and
it's
move
separation.
Well, that's true, but I mean, you know, you cross paths, and who knows? You know. You got a phone call again?
Yes,
I'm sorry.
Sir. Good morning. You're on the air.
Hey, Hank. It's Phelan.
Phelan.
Oh, Phelan. I'm sorry. Yeah, Phelan. I thought I was done with you.
I mean,
we used you for the last 4, 5, 6 months. I think we pretty much drained the tank, didn't we?
I sent him an email this morning saying, hey, it's not over yet.
send another 1,000.
We're going to have a suicide pact, Phelan. You know?
I think I got PTSD just from being around you.
That I can believe.
Yes.
You want your money back, Phelan?
Oh, send another 1,000.
Yep.
You want the
Y'all
money
got
back?
That number for the lawyer for the VA,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, you got the lawyer, yeah.
He wants to make an adjustment on his golf score.
Let me tell you, the day I met Don Harrison, I got an attorney.
Sick.
And a psychiatrist.
Yo, sick.
You definitely need a psychiatrist.
What do you got, guy?
Oh, the reason I called is I just want to remind everybody, when this thing comes up next year, make sure you sign up early and quick.
Yeah.
We got bombarded at the last minute. Right, Don?
Oh, absolutely, family. That's a good point. Very valid point. We just couldn't keep up with it. It was coming in so fast.
Here's the other good news is next year, and, you know, Don and I and others have already talked about it, people want to expand this whole thing of what we're doing. So I there's so many people come up with some, I mean, great ideas that it will be bigger, better, more events going on, and we already have got you on the committee.
Pictures say you need to get Phelan on there ready.
Mm-hmm. I think Phelan's going to take the lead.
Oh, is that right?
Are you the new chair, Phelan? Mm.
No. That was the last thing I was going to say. I got to go. So the last thing I was going to say is don't call me.
The only problem, Phelan, is we reinstituted the draft.
But one thing I'd like to say now on the radio since Phelan's on. Hey, Phelan, I want to thank you. You did a magnificent job. You did a lot of good work, and we appreciate that, and I want to thank you.
And I really enjoyed it.
And don't forget, the draft is on.
And this is a mandatory draft, by the way, Phelan.
You can't say no.
All questions go through my wife.
Okay. Thanks
we'll say please.
Thanks for all your hard work. Appreciate it. Yeah. Really do.
Outstanding.
All right, guys. We'll see you later, okay?
Okay.
All right. Later. Yeah, he dropped off all that financial stuff from yesterday. I got to turn it over to the accountant, and hopefully I'll be ready at the breakfast, and you can give me a big check, Don.
Yes, and I think that's the plan. But we also have to cross-reference that list with the list we have at Golden Ocala.
Exactly.
Because we have a lot of, I have to write a lot of thank you notes.
Yeah, well, I've got some people who can help us with that, and I know Mary and Golden Ocala talked about that, but yeah, that's important that people said, you know, be told thank you. Yeah, you know, thanks for coming out. And it went well, very few glitches. So
the biggest problem we had was the rain that happened.
Well, you know, it really didn't happen to the end, though.
It was right there at the end.
People were just finishing up. We made a convert to the golf game. My son-in-law never played. And now, you know, my daughter called me the other night. She created a monster, Dad. You gave him a set of clubs, and he's out here wanting to hit them all the time. You know?
I have some free lessons available.
Well, yeah. I think I talked to Steve, too. He says he's going to help him out with that a little bit.
I thought I heard her also say that he was taking him to bed with him.
Well, yeah, it's like being in the Marine Corps. You sleep with your rifle. You know?
Did you ever sleep with your rifle? Well, the Army guys sleep with their guns.
I don't think.
Also, you know, I think the biggest glitch was Robert with the photography. He never took enough pictures of
you
and I.
Film in the camera.
You and I.
Film it, yeah.
Oh, is that what I was supposed to have done? The film? Oh, I'm sorry.
He never took the cap off the lens.
There was a lot. He took a lot, and another guy took a lot. How many photos did you take that night?
Somewhere around 250.
Yeah, he told me the other guy took, I think he said, 800 photos.
Sir, he was cranking around, but he was doing a lot different than I was.
And he told me I was the best looking one out there.
So he was legally
people
blind.
People do lie.
He was legally blind.
Definitely.
Yeah, I think he legally blind, a little unbalanced.
Did you catch where he was from by chance, sir?
No, I didn't. I know that they've used them before out there.
Dominican Republic.
Is that originally? By the way, there were blind golfers out there, too. And those guys had a ball.
They did.
And the guys working with them had a ball.
Yes.
Matter of fact,
one of the blind golfers came in third.
Yeah.
Third place. Yeah. Hank and I couldn't even make the cutoff. He made third place.
And didn't lie about his score, either.
Because he couldn't even see it. So.
Yeah, there were blind golfers, folks in the wheelchairs, and those blind golfers had a great time. Yeah,
they really did.
Guys working with them, spotting the ball, had a great time. Everybody had a good time. Listen, let's play. If you got time, we'll play a little trivia this morning. I'll be easy on you because I'm in a pretty good mood today. So,
jeez, that's unusual.
It is.
You're
unusual,
in a good mood.
Yeah. Well, uh-oh. I'm lying. I'm not.
Vivian must have gave him a blanket when he was sleeping outside.
I got that flu shot yesterday, and all day yesterday I felt like I had the flu. I was aching, pain. I thought I was coming down with a fever, and feel better this morning. But last night was not a good night.
That thing is kind of dangerous if you.
Well, I was at the VA, you know, and she kept on sticking that needle in me. I assume it was the flu. She was, maybe it was something else. You know?
Well, that's why you got sick, because you're at the VA.
No. Hank has made a couple of enemies up there. You better be careful.
The truth will set them free, too.
Yes, it will.
While we're waiting on somebody to call in about the trivia.
This is an easy one. I got an easy one.
But remember, we got
forgot the restaurant stuff because I got some Cody things, but I've got the Walmart card.
You got the Walmart card.
Yeah, I got
a $20
Walmart card if you want
to
play.
Okay, while they're waiting, can I go ahead and say what I got to say?
Oh, absolutely. I'm sorry. It's all about that.
Anyway, Brady Owens Post 7193 is having his dinner dance, and it's coming up Saturday, November the 2nd of 2013. It starts promptly at 6:30 is when the seating will begin, and dinner dance starts at 7 p.m. That's November the 2nd, Saturday evening at 6:30 when seating will take place. And there's only one other thing that you can do now. You can purchase a ticket for the dinner dance at $35 per head. And, of course, you can still go on the patrons list at $5 per head. And we're asking that you continue to support us because we're still in the process of building the Brady Owens / VFW Post / Community Center. And we ask that you continue to support us in that effort. It's the Brady Owens VFW 7193 and the Ladies Auxiliary Annual Dinner Dance being held at the Ocala Elks Lodge, 702 Northeast 25th Avenue in Ocala. For more information, we ask that you please call 352-351-3599, and also 352-629-9347, and 352-620-0476. Thank you so much for your time.
Well, you have a short one this morning. Not that's
I don't
it.
Think we're getting any callers.
Well, that's okay. Then, they don't have to call.
Let me take a minute.
I heard a phone ring, but that's it.
Let me take a minute and thank some of the other people that really helped us, Hank, Masons from the 15th District and the Shriners. They were fantastic. We have to thank the Marine Corps League, Old 61. Couldn't have done it without them. And we've got folks like Bob Schmidt that owns the Seven Sisters, and we have the Wayne's World. Those folks all kicked in and helped us in their way.
The other one
so did Homewood Suites. Homewood Suites
yeah, yes. real, Homewood real Suites good to
us. They gave us some comp rooms and also discounted some rooms. So
I mean, it was a team effort. It was a real team effort to make this thing go.
Don't forget Mr. Roberts. Gosh, that man's awesome to do what he did.
It's Mr. and Mrs. Roberts, as I've been corrected.
Okay.
And,
please.
And we thank them all from the Golden Ocala. They were superb.
Yeah, I agree. Listen, no one wants to play trivia, so we'll keep on. That's the way to shut us up is play trivia with us.
Yeah, right. Well, we got Halloween working on us, too.
Well, I see.
Well, Halloween and Wayne's World thing is coming up. I don't have that right in front of me.
I don't either, but it's.
I know the haunted house thing and all of that.
It's fantastic. I heard it's funny. I'm going to go out there and check it out because they have a haunted house, then they have the maze, and they have all that stuff. And I
hope you go to the maze and sort of not make it back out the other side.
You know, the rats always find their way out. piece of cheese on the other end.
You mentioned that. I realize now that those guys you served with didn't know the house mouse story.
They know it now. Oh, the mouse. That's an interesting story. When you're the toughest guy in the squad, they make you the
make
mouse.
Make you the mouse. Little rat.
Yeah, exactly. That's something I'm very proud of. That's almost as bad as having the good conduct medal.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry, Curly. You got two of them?
I got two. Thank you.
I actually earned one myself, too.
Oh,
yeah, I did.
No, don't
I
say
did.
That to
I
me,
did.
Please.
Well, I was smarter than you. I know how to, you know, I know do get in trouble but not get caught. You know. So.
Well, you know, that was the badge of courage, I guess.
Or something like
to
that.
To be good back in the 60s.
That was good. Hey, listen, we're probably going to wrap up. We're getting ready to. You don't want to play trivia with us this morning. That's okay. We'll play next week. If I remember, you know, someone gave, besides Cody, some other guys, Pete gave me some things to do with the trivia. I keep on forgetting to bring them in. So.
Well, why don't we play? Curly.
Yes.
No, I want the right answer. Having the right answer is important.
Yeah, well, I was going to give the answer if I knew it, but the whole idea is I can't win the $25 gift certificate because that's a part of our thing that we do for the people.
Yeah.
Curly, what's the senior leadership branch of the Navy?
The senior leadership branch of the Navy?
Yeah.
The Navy is, of course.
Oh, God. Oh. You know.
You flubbed that one. You flubbed that. You struck out, Curly.
Yeah. It's sad. It's really sad.
The Navy, the Marine Corps.
Thank you. It was the United States Marine Corps.
You know I knew that. I'm just messing with your head.
You know, I hope everybody keeps their socks on. Mm-hmm. They'll be on TV tonight. Boston Red Sox.
The game starts at 7:30, 8 o'clock, something like that.
I think they won last night.
Yes, they did.
Temperature was, what, 47, 48 degrees?
That's good playing temperature.
Don't you love it when you see everybody?
Not when they win, you know.
Is the Sox won twice now?
No, one.
Just one?
Last night was the first game. Yeah,
they won the first game.
It was exciting. It was a lot of fun watching it.
It's been many years ago they won the whole thing, but it's been so long ago nobody remembers.
You know, I tell the story all the time. If you lived in Boston all those years, I mean, this is a true story. I knew relatives that their final wish was to have seen the Red Sox win the World Series.
Yes.
I actually told you that. The one thing they regret, not being closer to their children or something. So when they finally won. And
what's the old saying? When the Red Sox win the World Series, my grandfather's going to roll over in his grave.
Yeah. I heard that.
All right, listen, we're going to shove off again. Thank you for listening. We appreciate it. We'll play trivia next week if we get a chance. By the way, next week I've got some people coming in talk about some legal issues. They run a nonprofit for veterans. legal issues across the board. They can give you some advice on anything from home foreclosures to benefits, and they're good people. They're a nonprofit out of Orlando. They come up here periodically, so they're coming on next week to talk about that. And we're going to shove off, and I want to thank you for your service, and God bless America, everybody.
To the prairie, to the oceans wide with foam, God bless America, my home sweet home.
Ocala's Information Station, 13. 13-